It's not an educational book. It's a funny, you know, flying by the seat of your pants fucking life story of mine, which was a pretty crazy life, I'll tell you, you know. Poker in those days, you know, in the little city, little houses that we used to play in, you know, little back streets and that, it always sort of like, you always got the gambling, like the thug gambling villainy types used to play in them type of games, you know, yeah. Hang around them type of games, you know. So but I guess you automatically sort of mixed in with them. I used to carry on regularly, you know. It wasn't winning the money, it was getting on with the money that was tough sometimes, you know. Yeah, I mean, there's some great stories in this book about the, you know, getting on from the poker games and driving to him in the middle of the night with a gun in the pocket, and it's an exciting book, and all the way through I've tried to make it funny, you know. There's some great funny stories in there, really funny. I mean, there's a story in the book where we robbed this shop, we took the panel out the bottom of the door, and we took one van load of cigarettes and stuff, and we came back with the van for the next load, and there's a police car outside, and the policeman was crawling through the panel at the bottom with boxes of cigarettes and putting them in his car boot. He was stealing them, you know. Everybody was stealing them. And then the next day, in the newspapers, the guy who owned the shop, he put that he'd lost twice as much as he'd lost. So he was stealing off the insurance. You know, it just went on, you know, everybody was at it. There's a good story in the book where I'm playing in this game above Johnny Dunn's. It used to be a restaurant in Holland. I got broke in this game, and there was an antique dealer in the game, so I got fucking broke. And I looked at my friend, and he looked at me, I says, come on. About 3 o'clock in the morning, we walked out like, and we went to this local auction place, you know, and they had a big grandfather clock in the window for sale, you know. So anyway, we put the window in and we got this fucking clock out, you know. And it was like a fucking, it's, you know, it was like a, it sounded like a brass band, you know. Imagine all the charms going, you know, it was like a fucking, we walked in with it like a coffin, you know. A noisy coffin. And we fucking stood it up there and I said, fucking deal me in, boys, you know. I want a guy's apartment off me once. The guy, I mean, he fucked me. I played, he lost all his money, so I played for him. I said, I'll play for you. He only had a little bit left. I managed to win him all his money back. And then the amount of money he gave me, you know, for playing for him was a fucking joke. So then me and this other guy started to play him, you know, with a bit of money he gave me and this other guy. And I fucking busted him. I want all his money off him now. So now he's nearly crying. So I said, well, what have you got for me? You know, I mean, you didn't give me fuck all. I'm not giving you fuck all. So anyway, I agreed that I could rent his apartment, and anytime I got a nice chick, because he lived in the posh area, you know. So anytime I got a nice chick, I could go back and fuck her in his apartment, you know. So I used to go and bang on the door, 3 o'clock in the morning, he'd open the door with this fucking sheet around it. I go, get on the fucking settee, you know, and I jump on the bed. You know? Oh, I'll take guys around there for a game of poker and stuff, you know. Yeah. The only thing I really knew I had a talent for was shagging, you know, because I could never get a girl to fucking leave me. But poker sort of sneaked up on me, you know. I used to lose to start with, but eventually I started busting these games, and eventually I didn't get invited to them. They used to change the game, you know, without telling me, change the house where they was playing, you know. And I'd arrive at the house and it was somewhere else, the game, you know. I remember we were arriving at one house once and this guy's on the phone and he's speaking in Turkish and he's speaking in Arabic and he's speaking in fucking Russian, you name it. And I'm sat there waiting and he says to me, David, he says, nobody's coming to the game. They've seen your car outside. They're all driving by. They don't want to fucking play, you know. So I eventually had to start going in bigger circles, you know, Leeds, Bradford, Birmingham, Nottingham, and all these places, you know, and then she up to London, and then across to Vegas, and the rest is history.